in theory, it should be live. So I now await this fine Gasper, first one in. He says, "What? You're not live, Gaspar." Let's switch this to live chat and let's pop out the chat like a zit. New pin to chat. Okay. All right. So Gasper, how are you? Please do a video and audio quality check. To make sure it's proper scrotocol for the fine audience that God knows why you all watch this crap. Are we good, Gasper? Hello, Jack, Colton. Oh yeah, we're no longer on Thursdays. It's a Wednesday night gig. Oh, Gasper's on the train home. That Chattanooga choo-choo, won't you choo-choo me home? Gasper, a working man. God bless you, Gasper. Soon, we await Gasper to be executive vice president of Micro Center. That's going to be kick rectum. And we all get discounts. Or he would say piss counts. I would probably say piss counts. So wishing you. Listen, Gasper, I always enjoyed. I didn't have a problem with mass transit when I lived in New York, and I certainly enjoyed trains because, for the most part, I assume you see like the regular people at those regular time slots. So, did you do a little socializing? Now you've been working that job what for almost a year? Yeah, have you met some people on the train that you will sit with? Or is it just a mixed bag? Jack asked me my favorite video game. I love Halo. It's the whole franchise, especially Halo 3, but I didn't like getting sniped. But we're going to be playing Infinite War soon or whatever. Halo Infinity. Tanner in the house. We don't micro-centi here up in Canada. Okay. Oh. Gasper corrected me. We don't refer to it as mass transit. We refer to it as ass transit. Well, I'm not familiar with a video game named Thomas the Train, but I'm sure they have something out there for the kiddies. But yeah, I like Halo. I do play a little bit of Call of Duty. I'm not good at either of them. I did play GTA 5 with Danny Minnick. Didn't realize how violent the game was. I was like, holy crap. So, yeah. Anyway. So Gasper, all signals are good. All right, Gasper is doing the... someone you usually get a ride. Someone is your chaperone, chauffeur. Or you do a bike rental. Okay. Are you going to be working on getting a car at one point? Is that on the radar? It's an expensive thing to fuel it and insure it. But, Tanner's a call of biddy. How are you, Tanner? Are you freezing up there in Canada? How's your weather? How you doing up there? And, I also wanted to ask you, because Tanner's a brilliant photographer and he does a lot of extreme photography. Are you still doing the extreme photography when you go up on top of the buildings? Peter in the house. How are you, Pete? I checked the weather in Long Island earlier, Smithtown. It was like in the 40s. You're getting a little bit of a... How is it now? You just missed Waz. Listen, I'm on the... I receive his daily... I'm on his joke list, and he has about a couple of hundred people, in his tech-centric group, and he shares jokes with us. It's really a lot of fun. Oh, it's 33. Yeah, that's damn. One more degree higher, you'd be in good shape. So that would be 34. Oh crap! It's hailing over by you, Gasper. Well, it's a good thing you don't have a car then. You're using ass transit because Hell can dent your vehicle. Liam in the house. EMAV check has passed successfully. Thank you, Liam. Thank you. Oh, you're getting a snowstorm this evening. I thought we were all done with the snow. Peter says it's been raining nonstop for 3 days in a row. I guess good for the plants. But, yeah, that could be a mess. Okay, one of my friends, Manny, is going to be joining in. So this is the pre-show, 9:52. The official start time is 10. We're just warming up the crowd. Okay, you're still doing the rooftop photography. All right, that's good, Tanner. I tell you, listen, he gets into precarious situations on the top of very tall buildings up in Canada, and he takes these unbelievable shots. Tanner, let me ask you something. What camera are you using for you're doing people photography, right? And you're also doing the building photography. What's your current camera? What are you using? Yeah, Peter recommends to make sure you hit the dislike button. Yes. And by the way, is Miss Evangeline, the Klingon princess, is she in the house? Please, I must know if the princess is here. This is a little bit of a just light casual chat tonight. It's all good. What about Schittsburg? Liam got lots of flooding here in Pittsburgh. Oh, Gasper's vulgarity autocorrect corrected that to Schittsburg. We got nearly 3 inches of rain that lasted 2 days. I don't know. Start building the ark. I don't know. Those Tesla Cybertrucks, do they float? Yeah, no, Peter, definitely I want to share with you what I'm doing on the real estate side. All right, so Tanner is doing his photography with a Sony A7, I guess Mark III, but I'm upgrading to the Sony A7 IV for my trip to Japan later this year. Wow. Listen, Tanner, I hope you take a ton of photographs. I would really like for you to pick maybe 20 of them that we can share on a future live webcast. That would be great. Yeah, Peter, I'm going to talk about the new computer. It's actually pretty good. Cassius says no autocorrect. So, Vin, are you in the house yet? Because, certainly, well, all of you are fairly tech-centric and you're into cameras. I do have a question. Yeah, I got it. I really like the Young LA brand is good. They make nice quality stuff. I like the sweatpants, which I'm wearing now. It's nice cotton. And Gymshark is also pretty good. My friend Aziz told me about these companies. So very good. Gasper, you might need to go to Japan in 2025. Oh, you might be. Okay, you corrected that. You might be going. Okay. Yeah, listen, I heard it's fabulous. Just don't be a douchebag like Johnny Somali. Did you ever see that idiot on YouTube? My God. Kevin Lawrence in the house. How are you, Kevin? How is your wife and the kids doing? And a belated happy Easter. Kevin is one of the locals down in Miami, and a brilliant musician and who streams his music live. And good to see you, Kevin. I'm just starting to ramp up the weekly webcast, though I'm shifting it to Wednesday at 10. So yeah. Anyway, here's the question. We're 9:56, or is it? Yeah, still not official start time. Big deal. Good, good. Good to hear that you're doing well. Yeah, actually, Kevin joined me and my sister-in-law, Karen, at a local Italian joint. Let me see if I remember. Let's see how good the memory is now at almost 63. Big Louie's, right? Big sloppy Italian red sauce stains on the shirts. Right, Kevin? Tanner says, what does more stuff mean? And you're gonna hire one of those maid girls. I missed this. Maybe something I said on the stuff. Yes, coupon Karen. Yeah, she doesn't go by that moniker anymore. But yeah. So So I'm waiting for Vin to pop in because I do have a photography question which came via my niece. Yes. Yeah, it was a while ago. How long? All right, Kevin, try to calculate that. How long ago did you meet us up for dinner? And yeah, I agree. I actually, the beachside condo is now like a normal home. It actually has furniture and a dining room table. I finally got rid of the computer table in the middle of the freaking where the dining room should be. I have sofas that you can sit on. I'm redoing the studio side now. That's the current project. So definitely let me know if your travels get you up to my area or I have to drag my ass down to Miami. Yeah, it has to be at least 10 years. Easily. That's fun. It's fun. You know, and you know, I know one of the viewers was talking about games before, Jack. We're actually getting the Halo crew together again. And it's funny because we were having the chat on LinkedIn, and one of the fellas said, gee, I guess we realize that we're old when we're talking about scheduling Halo games on LinkedIn. And my response to that was, gee, if you guys consider yourselves old, that makes me ancient, but all in good fun. Tennis is Miss Klingham Princess. From what she was saying in Piscord, she was, but there's a heart in the way. She was, going through some stuff. Okay. So she has personal stuff on the agenda. Understood. Okay. All right, so we wish the Klingon Princess well. Oh, wait a second. 9:59. It's almost ready for the official kickoff of the Wednesday night Alfred.TV webcast. I even have trouble getting adjusted to Wednesday night at 10. But I did get a workout in. I got a lot of stuff done today, so it was all good. Are we counting down the seconds? 9:59 and what? Whoop-de-doo. You know why? I do the shout-out for the Klingon Princess. I'm gonna dig deep into the mic so you get the full audio quality of this. I must have spoken. Can just someone tell me when it's 10 o'clock? You never did the official webcast? I did it last Wednesday. Oh, I didn't say what I'm going to say now. You're correct. I forgot. I haven't done it in so long. Okay, it's 10 p.m. 10 urine M. Here we go. You ready? Welcome to station WFCK. The only thing missing is you. I also didn't do any gongs last Wednesday. I forgot to, like, turn on the iPad. But there you go. Whoop-de-doo. Mac King. He's ready for the eclipse. This is where I make the Mitsubishi eclipse joke, and some of you don't get it because the car is not really on the radar anymore. When is that? Next week? And is that an event that will burn out your retina? Right? Do we destroy our eyesight looking at that thing with the naked eye? Is the Stephen P. Jobs kitchen fit? Yes, Peter. Yeah, beachside. Beachside's done. Well, it was the Stephen P. Jobs impact windows on studio side, which were paid for 50% by the selling of the Steve Jobs business card. My nephew, Mike Mack, Michael in the house. How are you, Michael? Tennis is not ready to see Jasper's booty? Or maybe you meant Gasper. He's spelled with a G. It's G-A-S. Gaspar. And by the way, it was really good to see that Ron Knights is still alive. And we got to get Ron in here and on the show. I don't know if 10 o'clock might be too late for him. But it's good when I have Ron around because then I'm not the oldest guy in the crowd. Casper says yay. Yay. Who's yay? Isn't that a rapper? So he says that the rapper Ye, who is the rapper now known as Ye? He said that Ye is getting home to defecating. How would you know that the rapper Ye is defecating right now? I don't understand this, Gasper. Sometimes you really confuse the F out of me. You're right. Yeah, Mike Mac and Chris PC. Those are great commercials. I love the Mac versus PC commercials. Yeah, Christopher May, he was all about Windows Vista on a whatever laptop. Well, I had given him both of me. They had old Mac PowerBook whatevers back in the day. I still got one of them. But who is that rapper with Ye? Who is that? Oh, probably Kanye. Now Ye. Hooray. Yeah, I tell you, speaking of rappers for a brief moment, brief instant, I am so sick and tired of how YouTube is literally flooded with Diddy clickbait stuff. I mean, yeah, a lot of allegations, a lot of serious allegations. I guess it's kind of interesting to see how it all plays out, but now everyone has theories now and just holy crap. And I still want to know how you know that Kanye is defecating right now, Gas. Remember, that's another story. It's a shitty story, but we'll skip that over. But I'm sure you've seen all the stuff about Puff Daddy, P. Diddy, Urine Diddy, whatever. Hey, listen. Could have been a Shizer party there. Who the hell knows? But yeah, I'm like just so over it. Give me a break. And Lizzo saying I quit, but now she's back. I mean, it's like, whatever. It's just the common drama. But a lot more important things going on in the big picture out there. Mac King says, what's your favorite Macintosh Mac system? I think one of my personal favorites was the Mac 2 CI. That was a great system. I love the cheese grater, the Mac Pro 5.1, 5.1. Trash can's like a work of art, and it's the current system. But I did get a new iMac M1, bottom of the barrel. Best Buy was blowing them out at night for $950. Liam says, P. Diddy did too much P. diddling. Yeah. And Mike said, yeah, it's happening. Yeah, Mike. Well, Vin's going to call in with some of the latest crop of conspiracy theories. I heard one where Diddy is working undercover with the FBI. Yeah, whatever. It is what it is. Oh, wow. Just got a scam text. Dear Linda, I'm Nicole. I lost my mobile phone. I will still come to your beauty salon to inspect it tomorrow afternoon. We will discuss the specific capital increase issue in person tomorrow. Oh, I think we must call this person. And what's your bet? Is it a Google voice number? All right, so I just got the scam text. What a lame. Dear Linda, who the hell writes Dear Linda? If you're texting someone, it's going to be, Linda, I'm Nicole. Linda, it's Nicole. Crappy. Who the hell is writing these scripts? Garbage. $20,000 in Bitcoin, I'll rewrite these scripts. But I'll just take the $20,000 and I won't write their scripts. But we're going to call this person. Let's get Skype up. Yes, we do make outbound calls on this live show. That's terrible. That is so terrible. All right, let's call the number. Fucking idiots. Here we go. Not impressed.
Please leave your message for 2672430.
I tell you, you know, these scammers, they don't pick up. They don't pick up. Unbelievable. Hello, your computer's... text them back. Yeah, the text back is just, I want to get them on the phone. Sometimes I do get them on the phone, as you know. But yeah, not impressed with the scammers these days. I mean, you know, we like good trolls and we like good scammers. We don't like the shitty ones. It's just not good. We will discuss the specific capital increase issue in person tomorrow. Okay, can someone look up the 267 area code is where? Where is it? Just Google it. Press buttons. Help me out here. I'm just curious where. Just look at, yeah, no, it is a shame. It's good entertainment, you know. Yeah, I welcome those, you know, those emails with the phone number for tech support. Yes. It's in Philadelphia. Okay. Yeah. Like I said, she texted me, should have been by her phone, she should have picked up. Not impressed. Yeah, right. Muck says, yeah, it's South Asia. Somewhere in, yeah, somewhere over there. Listen, when I got a scammer to break character, and I spoke with them as a scammer of record, and I said, I got to ask you something. Why do you do this? And the response was, because, you know, you are all rich Americans. So from their point of view, we're all wealthy Americans. And, you know, listen, they see the media. They see, you know, they see, you know, David DeFranco's YouTube videos. I got a Tesla, a house, this, that, lots of computers, gaming systems. I mean, they see our movies. They see the entertainment. They see the concerts. Yeah, we're all FF class. Now, I don't think it was Russia. But, you know, it's whatever. Oh, hi, Mark. I love that phrase. It's so good. But yeah, so they didn't pick up. Oh, well. Try again next time. Fuckers. Whatever. Anyway, let me look at my notes. So tonight, the first Wednesday of every month is the NatMac meeting. It's a Zoom call. It's a hosted Zoom call. It's from our local South Florida Macintosh users group. It's called NatMac because it had dreams of becoming national. Now, I'd really like to send an invite and have you all in on one of the meetings. It's only a small handful of people. I think tonight it was like six. The main speaker, the tire on his Tesla blew out. I think he put duct tape on it or something like that to try to patch it. Didn't work too good. Or maybe I'll see if we can just simulcast it on our Discord server. But the main speaker wasn't there. So one of the members started asking questions and we got on discussions of cryptocurrency and we were all over the place. It was really pretty good. You have a good memory, Tanner. Yes. I had a user group called South Florida, one word, South Florida Computer Users of Macintosh, or SCUM. Yes, we had actually two meetings. There's actually video footage of the first meeting back in 1992 or something like that. But but NatMac is still alive, and we actually had some pretty good discussions. It was good. But one of the members, she has a 27-inch iMac with a 1 terabyte internal spinning hard drive, and it's like full with 960 gigs of what? So she was running Disk Inventory X or Disk Inventory Triple X or Daisy Disk or Daisy Duke or one of those stupid apps that does an inventory on the hard drive. I mean, the woman's probably in her mid to late 70s. I'm going to say, like, how much bit torrenting are you doing? Like, how much crap do you have on your computer? But, you know, listen, when you run out of storage, your system chokes out. But be that as it may, it was a very good meeting. Adam was present. Scott, very good. But yeah, so we have to might have to simulcast it. By the way, I helped one of my neighbors set up a new laptop. She got a new laptop and a new stinkjet printer. It was an HP laptop and running Windows 11. Some of the Mac people say, I'm sorry. Yeah, but listen, no problem. And after it's all set up, I open up the Edge browser. And I loaded, like, you know, yahoo.com. And the thing sat there and timed out. And she was getting, like, you know, 200 megabits down, 100 gigawatts up. So it's not her internet speed. And after a while, digging through all the control panels to put my computer on the desktop so I can look at the specs besides dust on the system, it was a Pentium chip that I never heard of. 1 gigahertz. And I looked it up. You know, I researched the chip, and it was like meant for students and educators. So this must have been like a bare-bone laptop with 4 gigs of RAM, really just to do word processing. It choked on a website. So I said, Helen, where the hell did you get this piece of shit? And she said, QVC. I'm like, oh my God. What balls for them. I don't remember, like I said, the chip, like it wasn't an i3 or an i5 or an i7 or a Celeron. It was some other weird, and it had the Pentium name on it, some low-powered piece of shit. I told her to send it back. And based on the recommendations that you all made on our Discord server, I recommend Lenovo laptops. So listen, you know, the Macs are expensive. I love the MacBook Air. I love the MacBook Pro. But someone's in a budget for $500, $600, $700, they can get a pretty good system from Lenovo for that amount. So yeah, she's sending it back. Is it called an N200 or something? I don't remember, James. Michael said, was she running Bonsai Buddy? I don't even know what that is. But anyway, yeah, Peter says, porn must not work well on that laptop. But yeah, I think QVC, what balls, spelled the way I say it, BAWLS, what balls for them to sell that piece of shit, especially if they're, you know, selling it to people that are older that aren't really tech savvy. They're going to think they're getting a great deal. I think she paid like $800 for that piece of shit. But she did send it back, and hopefully she gets a Lenovo, because I happen to like this ThinkPad line. Remember, they used to make the systems for IBM. So here's a question for you all, because a lot of you are tech-centric. My lovely niece, Alexa, she has a baby on the way in August. It's a baby boy. And she wants a camera for taking really nice photos and video. And the camera she was looking at was a Canon G7 X Mark II. Now, I looked it up real quick. The camera's from 2016. Of course, the first thing I said was, well, I don't know, what phone do you have? She has an iPhone 13. I don't know, I shoot a lot of pictures with my iPhone 15 Pro Maximus. The videography and the photography is outstanding, especially with all that AI backend. I have to work very hard when I use my real Canon cameras, like the Canon and the Fuji. I got to work those pictures to make them look good. So I don't know, what do you all think? My initial recommendation was, I don't know, Alexa, just look at your cellulite plan and go from an iPhone 13 to an iPhone 15 Pro. I mean, the Pro Max is just a bigger phone, right? There's no difference in the lenses. Doesn't the Pro have the 3 lenses? I think that would be the way to go. Or you tell me, should she be looking at a point and click? I think it's just the whole thing of wanting something different. But I think if her and her husband, you know, have iPhone 15 Pros, won't they be taking plenty of pictures that at a certain point in time, no one's going to want to look at anymore as they're posted on every social media platform? What do you think? Should she drop $700 on a 2016 camera? Or just upgrade the phones? That's what I thought. My sister has my purple iPhone 14 Pro Maximus with a terabyte of storage. She'll be babysitting. She'll be taking a shit ton of pictures. Thanks, Pete. Mike says, would you ever use the point and click afterwards? Seems like a waste. I say waste. I tell her to get a Sony A6400 if she wants an actual camera. Okay. And what do those things cost? Is that the, or is there an older model that's a better deal? Matt Geek says an iPhone is better than that Canon. Yes, I agree. AI is the way to go. iPhones have wider exposure latitude than point and shoots. It's more steps to post to the internet from a dedicated camera. Yes, good point. And yeah, what are you going to do if you're using the camera? You still got to do some post-processing. James says, I just prefer old way of using a camera. Oh, James, let me tell you something. When I go out there with the Canon 5D Mark IV or Hor, and hearing the clunk of that mirror, no, I enjoy using the camera. But like I said, you have a, you know, a new mommy and daddy, you know, a Sony A6400. I am going to make a note on the Sony. These are very good comments because I told her, listen, I'm going to talk to you all and get back to her. But those are good points. So that's about 950. So Sony. Yeah, I definitely should stay away from that Canon point and clip. But also, Michael, you point about posting. And of course, the whole thing with the iPhone, the AI photography. Good points. Very good. I will share that with her. And go from there. Nice. Oh, Tanner, on that Sony A6400, I assume that will also take some decent video, right? Hello, Blue. I assume that will also take video. The cameras are so multifunctional these days. You know, Peter, you asked me about that iMac. So for those of you that didn't see the video, I was injured from I had a tendon rupture in my foot. I was on crutches for about 2.5 months. I wanted to get a new computer because I'm using that 2013 Mac Pro trash can, which works great. 3 monitors, everything's good, except for doing like upscaling and rendering. It's slow. It would render or upscale video footage 1 frame every 4 seconds. So I went balls to the wall and got the FF class Mac Studio with the M2 Ultra, with the 250 gigawatts of memory, whatever the highest config. I went with 4 terabytes of internal storage, not 8. So the only thing I didn't do was 8 terabytes. With tax, that thing was $8,200. I was going to finance it over 12 months on the Apple card, whatever. And that was going to replace the trash can, be the new system so I can run the newer versions of the broadcast software and be up to date with my browsers. That's like the biggest frustration. And then, of course, get really fast rendering with the Topaz Labs product. And Topaz Labs, the AI upscaler for video, it was giving me about 7 frames per second. Be that as it may, I loaded up all the licensed software and then shit stopped working. Browsers stopped working. It was because Sonoma was too new. Apple had a return policy, so I took a refund on the thing. And whatever. So at this point, I'm waiting for the M3 Ultra or M3 Extreme version of the Mac Studio, which will replace. But Best Buy was getting rid of the first gen low-end iMac. M1, 256 gigs of storage, 8 gigs of RAM. I got the purple one, so it has the extra 8 cores. It has 4, 2 Thunderbolt and 2 USB-C ports. And whatever. And I rendered, as some of you saw, the 1984, I'm going to say it right, Leaser demo. It did a beautiful job at upscaling the video, and it was cranking out between 3 to 4 frames a second. So $950 for that low-end piece of shit iMac. I bought my sister a $3,500 one, the new M3 purple one, loaded. But I was really very impressed with what the M1 did. And looking at the processor, It looks like what was slamming was that FFmpeg process. I guess that's the main drain. I don't know if it's using the neural engines or any of the other crap. But overall, fairly impressed with the output. So I have the iMac in a hutch in the living room. I remote into it from the trash can, and I just give it jobs. Here, render this, upscale this. It's great. Sits and rots, low-powered, beautiful. I did put a 4-terabyte Thunderbolt drive on it, which cost me, it was not cheap, it was about $550, because I choked out the 256. I actually wiped the internal drive. When I went to do a software update, it says, you don't own this machine. So I must have wiped out something at a secure, at some security level. But thank God for Reddit. And to apply an update from terminal, you can just use this command at the terminal level, and it worked. That command, sudo software update dash I dash A dash capital R. There's a space between the I, A, and the R. Whatever. Oh, the Klingon Prince is here. Oh, we gotta do the welcome to station WFCK. The only thing missing is you. Welcome, Miss Evangeline, the Klingon princess. Gasper, the first thing she writes is that Gasper huffs smegma. Well, to huff it, wouldn't it have to be airborne? So what? He scrapes it, heats it up, and then aerates it? Oh, it's disgusting. Yeah, the Klingon princess sure is here. Yeah, I used to use Apple remote access, you know, no big deal. But like I said, for $950, well, when I get the Mac Studio, that drive will go on it. But whatever, it does a pretty good job. And this circles back to what a few people told me, including Adam, when I was so frustrated. He said, "Oh, just get a Mac Mini on sale." But I like having the iMac with the screen. Great. You know, because like I said, you know, I can still sit in front of it. I did edit after the upscaling was done. I did the editing on that system and posted it to YouTube. So I'm glad some of you saw it and enjoyed it. Certainly a piece of history. And Vin, you had such a great comment that this is a very, very rare piece of video footage, because it was like 12 minutes of footage without me making one bad joke, one piece of vulgarity, nothing, not a zip. So, yeah, someone said, like, commented that it was scripted. It wasn't scripted. That was just my demo. And the gal, Gladys, if I remember her name correctly, she was like a high-level executive with the Board of Education. She was no dope, and she was a bit stoic, but that was her, how she presented. And, like, you know, when she said, like, that's amazing, when I changed the font and the font size, that was like her, like, saying, like, falling out of the chair, basically, you know? So it was very, she was very subdued on her reactions, but she was really impressed. And Evangeline says, just sticking my head in here for a bit, though. Still have plenty to take care of tonight before hopefully getting some sleep. Okay, I hope you get things under good control, Evangeline. Remember, just use your, what's the name of the Klingon sword? I don't know, just make a guttural sound like I'm Yiddish. It's something with a B, right? Peter, are you interested in the M3 Mac Pro? No, I want the, yes, no, yes. Because then I'd have slots, whoop-de-doo. I think the next thing I'm going to upscale is the booting the Lisa with no mouse. Where I had a little bit of the audio from the Aliens movie. No, not boner short. No, the yeah, there it is. The Bat-Leth. She wears it around her neck. She's a Klingon princess. What the hell you want? Oh, goodness. I'm looking at, yeah, I actually have notes on this crap. I saw the Kong Godzilla movie. I had no idea that it was the fourth installment of a series of movies that had same actors and actresses and what, the whole thing. So I went in there just seeing, you know, basically part four rhymes with door. I went in with like zero expectations. Beatus is wait for the M5. Look, if the iMac does what I need to do, screw it. Maybe I will. Just for the Star Trek reference. But I went to see that movie with zero expectation. It was actually surprisingly a very good movie. It was fun. Yeah, it was good. Yeah, they really got King Kong some heart. You know, so I do recommend that you see it. But you know, it was a smaller movie crew. Last movie, it was, you know, for Dune 2, because Dune 1 kind of sucked. Dune 2, we had, it was either 12 or 13 people. I mean, we took up most of the row. The Godzilla Kong movie was a group of five, and one person was just, the seating got screwed up, so he wasn't sitting with us. I was sitting next to Aziz. Adam was there. My friend Will, who we call Cyborg, like a 6'2" linebacker. And you know, Aziz is observing the Ramadan fast, and I know, you know, he said I'm gonna try to break fast at the movie. So I don't know if he was going to try to sneak in some food before the movie, but the movie started at like 7 o'clock. Anyway, I said, Aziz, what time is sunset? He said 7:40. And I see him look at his watch at 7:41. He pulls out this huge FF class burrito from Shitpulte that was stuffed into his hoodie and a bottle of water. So he took care of the proper protocol for eating after sunset. And Zalo, signing on late. You miss Waz, who is just here. Actually, it's funny. Waz says that he would like to bomb the Zoom meeting, the NatMac meeting. I really got to try to get him to do that. That would be fun. But anyway, that's the deal with that movie. Definitely check it out. What else? Oh, first of all, tomorrow is Dave DeFranco Sr., or he'll be in South Florida, Senor. Dave DeFranco Sr.'s birthday. And Dave and his wife, Debbie Dew, they're visiting me this weekend. They'll be staying at the Embassy Suites right next door. I can't wait to see both of them. And I tell you, how blessed am I that they made a specific tweak to their travel plans to come down and spend a few days with me down here. And then they're going to scoot up to Orlando to celebrate their, I don't know if it was their wedding anniversary, 40th, whatever the hell it is. So I did call Dave Jr. I said, hey, Dave, why don't you get your bony ass on a freaking plane and come down as well? I know, I should be able. How about during the summer? What's the summer? You've been saying come down during the summer for the past like 18 billion years, and it's hot as balls down here in summer. Matter of fact, we had a heat wave, all right? It was like it was hitting up upper 80s. I think it hit 90. It was a record breaker. And normally I'd have Pete on to talk about how his balls were hanging low. Pete from New Jersey, but Pete actually has some edit. He got some work. Paid video editing work. He's freelancing, freeballing. So we got to find someone else to pick up the weather segment. It's not an easy job to do. Pete's a tough act to follow from New Jersey, but Dave and Deb are going to be coming down. So I'm really looking forward to seeing them, and we'll see if maybe David surprises me, or maybe I'll drag his bony ass down here sometime during the summer, in which case I will drag his bony ass to the gym. He's eaten way too much Wawa and sheets. Anyway, hello, my brother Gary is in the house. How are you, Gary? Your son Michael's here too. So whatever. You want the Jigglypuff song? I think I got that here on the soundboard. Let's see. Yeah, here's Gasper. Did it play? There we go. Peter says the M4 will be built for tough. Yeah, kid, not Dave. Yeah, sure. It would have been nice if he came down, but I'm looking forward to seeing Dave Sr. and Deb. They're a lot of fun. Nice people. And then, like I said, I think they're doing, like I said, they're doing an Orlando run after that. Fellow YouTubers. Yeah, David's is a tech and family vlogger. I like to say vlog. It was soft as hell when it played. Really? Oh, we got to fix that. Really? The volume is low?
Jigglypuff, Jigglypuff.
All right, there we go. It's a little better. Do we have Justine going, oh?
Oh. Oh.
Yeah, all right. I mean,
whoa.
Okay, Justine makes the best sounds when she's unboxing crap. You know, the soundboard stuff, tremendous. Yeah, I don't know if he's come down for Halloween Horror Nights. He might be too scared. Yeah, they're extended family up in, they were originally New Jersey, I'm sorry, and then they moved to like bumfuck Pennsylvania with like, you know, where the horse and buggies are going and all that shit. Yeah, he's part of, OG YouTube, correct. Vin, get your Skype up because I think you're up next. I think I talked about all the garbage I had on my... Oh, I had a couple of... Wait a second. I had a couple of pictures and a video clip. I like to go out and take Easter Sunday sunrise photographs. So let's go to a preview. Hopefully it works. And we're going to fade in. And I'm going to show you a couple of the shots. So I went out at like 6:15 a.m. Sunrise was at like 7:20. So this was taking at an obnoxious, it was dark. This was just obnoxious. You know, I had to really push this with the video, with the photo editing software. But it still came out to be a pretty interesting photograph. Like I said, the colors just look a little whacked out just because it was so dark in the sensor. I then turned the camera, and I'm shooting with the iPhone 15 Pro Maximus. And so the moon was still up. You see the moon in the cloud structure. We can zoom in on that maybe, or either that or I'm going to screw everything up. Yeah, so the moon was there. And obviously the photo was noisy as hell because the light level was so low. I wanted to experience, it was nice being outside by the ocean. I'm very blessed. I do this every day. But I wanted to just get all the different variances in light. I then carved my name into the sand and set the picture to black and white and then tweaked up some of the grain and some of the sharpness and just a little bit of an interesting effect. And you can see my footprints as I'm pacing back and forth, waiting for the sun to rise, probably dropping way too many F-bombs for Easter Sunday. Praise the Lord, Jesus. And I got in on the rock structure. You know, the sun's coming up now. And I really liked the green. All right, so those are some of the rocks by our building. And let's zoom in. The iPhone takes amazing pictures. I mean, it really does. As I said earlier, you got to really work it with the other cameras. But I mean, the details, you know, pretty good. I'm editing with Luminar Neo. You know, I punched up the color punched up the color a little bit. It's an interesting shot. This shot, I use the iPhone, the 5X whatever zoom lens. And there was a car. There was a cargo ship. Good thing there's no bridges around. But just check this shot out. I mean, it doesn't look like a cruise ship. It looks like a, you know, some type of a cargo ship, but a pretty you're right, could have wrote Jesus in the sand. How's he going? Tanner said the Dino's feature in Lightroom by Utopia. Yeah, I actually subscribed to that suite. That's a good thing to know. Thank you for the heads up on that. I thought this shot was pretty, pretty cool. Let's see what else I got for it. Okay, so this was the official Easter Sunday 2024 photo. This is the official shot, and I did make prints and shared it with some of the neighbors. I am going to be offering the photographs for sale. It's been on the radar for a while, but right now I'm building the digital library, and this shot is just beautiful. Beautiful shot. And then, you know, we had a really big family Easter party, but we were so much enjoyment with all the families and friends that were there, we didn't take the group shot. So this was the very, very, very tail end. The sun, as you can see in the background, was going down. So this is my cousin Debbie and her husband Pat, and they were the hosts of Easter Sunday. Peter asked if I went to church, and this is a very, very religious group of my family members. So what I made sure to do, Peter, to answer your question, is I did drive through the parking lot at St. Ambrose Church around the corner from my home. So, and they did ask, I'm able to say with a straight face, when they say, did you go to church? I said, yes. And there we go. Vin, this shot I took for you. Here are three suggestions for movie night. Vin has been hosting movie night on the Discord server on Monday nights. And, we have some tech-centric and themed. I think Gasper did an anime thing last Monday. But I don't know if you ran any of these, but Triumph of the Nerds is a good one. And then the PBS for Pubic Broadcasting System, that's Steve Jobs. That PBS on Steve Jobs is great. It was called One Last Thing. And then this movie called Macheads, a fanboy documentary. These are really good. So let me know if you've heard of these, if anyone has seen them. But they're pretty good. So we'll try to cue these up for movie night. And by the way, since we're talking about Discord, someone post a link, please. If you're not a member, I suggest you join our Discord server. We have a nice group of people. It's a tech-centric crowd, but all in good fun. And this was just a frame grab from the Leaser video. Gotta love the frame grab, right? And whatever. Okay, so one more thing I have for you. I took one video clip at Easter Sunday. Like I said, we were so engaged with everyone that was in attendance, it didn't really cross my mind. So this was the FF class dessert spread. Here you go.
Well, looking at this dessert spread, and what's the first thing out of my mouth is, Jesus Christ. Well, it makes sense, right? It is Easter.
Listen to the laugh of one of the family members when I did the Jesus Christ.
Looking at this dessert spread, and what's the first thing out of my mouth is, Jesus Christ. Well, it makes sense, right? It is Easter.
So that was a dessert spread. Holy crap. And We had quite a mix of food. We had the leg of lamb, you know, I say lamb of God, and we had the Italian dishes. Any vegetable dish, I pointed at it and said, oh, that's decorative, right? You're not supposed to eat that. So yeah, the only bummer is that we did have a death in the family. My cousin's father-in-law died, and we had services for him on Saturday. So that was a real shocker. I got that text at 10 o'clock at night after the movie ended. I did attend the services. Ralph, who's the son, he did make it with his wife, my cousin Lindsay, to the Easter Sunday family get together. And of course, being around family was important. And he has two young children. And, you know, I walked out to him, gave him a hug. And I said, Ralph, listen, I assume you're in shock still. And he looked at me and said, yes. I said, that's normal. You gotta go with the flow. And, he kept a quiet demeanor. He embraced his children and he still celebrated with us. And we all move forward and life goes on. His father was 71 years of age. He had gotten hit with a very, very bad case of COVID-19 about a year and a half ago. And it left him with 24/7 vertigo. In other words, the room spinning all the time, day and night. And a year and a half of that, you know, things just kind of broke down in his system. And, you know, pneumonia took him down. You know, he was in the hospital. So that was a kind of a shitty thing. I did make one semi-crappy joke at the services. You know, the pastor was up there saying, you know, and in death, what's left? In death, what's left? Nothing but the stories. The stories about the individual and the times with the individual. And I leaned over to my cousin Cameron and I said, hey, Cam, when I drop dead, what will be left will be my 900 plus YouTube videos. My God, yes, I will go on. So that's that was the update. His axes and donuts. Matt the Gamer, I can feel my blood sugar spiking just watching the video. Yeah, no, it was definitely. And Mike says, make sure we watch Pirates of Silicon Valley, which we ran on the on our Discord server. It's great. It's a great movie. Mike, did you see those other three? Todd, you are so fucking late, Todd. Well, all right, Todd, answer honestly, what were you watching before this? What other stream were you watching? How dare you? Yeah. Todd says, I miss Waz, I know, but howdy there, Uncle. Howdy. Well, howdy there, Todd. Matt, where's the tip button? How much do you get to take your shirt off? Matt is one of the OG Halo players. He's now a doctor. What a filthy mouth he had back in the day. Matt, we're getting the OG crew back again for Halo. I know you have a wife and like three kids and a fourth one on the way. Or is it two kids and a third one on the way? But let me know if you're still able to play and I will invite you. We are really going to schedule a game. And it was funny because we were talking about scheduling the game on LinkedIn to the OG players. And they said, wow, we must be old if we're talking about scheduling Halo while we're on LinkedIn. I said, shit, if you guys are old, it makes me ancient. Matthew, too funny. How I would get pissed off and he would snipe me. And Mike, we were playing Halo 3 beta. Mike spawned on the other team. He kept on sniping me. And I was getting fucking pissed off. And at that time, they had the other team could hear you if they were in proximity to you. And I said, Mike, if you snipe me one more time, you're getting shit for Christmas. And some of the people on the opposing team were like, that guy just threatened that guy's Christmas presents. Oh, it was classic. You was watching Steph Pappas videos. She's a cute Greek on YouTube. What does she do? Does she cook or was she talking about politics or what's her gig? And I don't mean 1,024 megabytes. What a terrible joke that is. Matt said the fourth one just popped out. Well, Mazel Tov, L'chaim. I get that pretty good. Matt, yeah, good for you, Matt. You're repopulating the planet. And you know what else makes Matt really cool? He bought a ZR1. He has the C7 series ZR1 for the Canadians. That's a shout out to you, Tanner. Matthew, I'm going to say, how are you enjoying your four beautiful children? No, Matt, how are you enjoying your beautiful ZR1? Listen, Gary's wife used to get pissed. He didn't have pictures of his two sons in his wallet. He had pictures of his two Corvettes. Logan, the joke must be very clean. But no, congrats, Matt. Oh, that's funny. Logan says, I was transferring someone's passwords to the new computer. They had connected to a network call. It burns when IP. That's brilliant. Yes. Matt says, it gets me from point A to point B. Yes. Now, listen, that's nice, Matt. I'm glad you're enjoying the car. And speaking seriously for a very brief moment, congratulations on your fourth child, and I hope your wife is doing well. I'm expecting a great nephew. My niece Alexa has a baby in the queue, so we're looking forward to that. Todd says she does mostly mukbangs on her channel. Okay, she's a mukbanger. Sometimes I'll comment on David DeFranco's videos because in a lot of the videos, he does eat at some point. And I'll comment, yeah, another freaking mukbang video. But when I spoke to David and yelled at him for not coming down, he said he wants to be a call-in guest on the show. So we will drag his bony ass on as a guest caller. And speaking of bony ass, because Vin is our next caller, and Vin's a vegan. And Vin, I'm sorry, you need more protein. But once you get your Skype up and yeah. Yeah. And right. My favorite great nephew, right? He's my only great nephew. Tanner says, when are we going to do the webcam on the adult cam site? Okay. Just to let people know what we're talking about here. We had the idea, the brainstorm of let's bring this show as is to one of the, let me just get Vin, hang on. Hey, Vin.
Testes 1, 2, 3.
Testes 1, 2, 3. Are you sounding 5x5? I'm just explaining the whole thing to some people as far as the porn webcam sites. You know, the concept to be that we're going to bring this show as is on one of those porn webcam sites, and the joke is, there's going to be no pornography. The joke is to see how long I can talk about Mac OS and Apple products and other tech crap until the network operations center throws me the fuck off.
You know, I think this might be successful because, you know, I think the audience kind of overlaps, you know, the tech audience and the porn watching audience.
Wow, that's an interesting concept, then. You're saying that all the tech people and a certain percentage of incels, they're all on that site.
Yeah, I think the gooners and the tech crowd are kind of overlapping. So
Matt says put it in the gay section.
Yeah, you know, whatever. I mean, I think, you know, you might get someone who's, you know, needs to give his hands a rest, and he comes across you talking about the new Mac OS update, and, you know, maybe I'll stick around for a minute.
But you know, but really funny, if it got more people than here and it generated revenue, I might set like a new standard. Yeah, did you hear Marquise Brownlee
and
John Rettinger? They're all launching.
I think it will. I think you would get more. I mean, right now, let's see. You got 24 watching here. I think you'll get more if you do it on Chatterbait. I guarantee.
Well, Tanner, what was the site you were going to recommend? Tanner did some research. Listen, I don't want to spend a lot of money to set the account up.
No, you make all that money back, though.
Can you imagine?
No, you don't have to spend money. I think you just have to connect your bank account.
Whoa!
We'll have to do a lot more audio grabs from iJustine unboxing videos for the soundboard.
Oh!
Oh, you need one of those ASMR microphones.
Yeah. Well, listen, Logan says I would come and ask about stuff like how am I trying to migration assistant. Yeah. Well, listen, I would need the core audience here to go on, you know, as long as you're an adult, you know, so you don't get in trouble.
Yeah, I think by now most of your audience is adults.
No, you know? we haven't. Yeah, it skews towards an older crowd, so which is fine. Matt says, if I tip enough, you take off your shirt. Matt, I didn't shave my chest yet, so
No, it'd be funny if like you took off your shirt and then there was just another one underneath it.
That would be great. Yeah, there's a lot that could be done here. We really have to do it. And I have to figure out just, you know, the streaming software and how it. Listen, I'll tell you one thing. It will probably be the best looking and best sounding broadcast on that platform.
Yeah.
It'll be pretty good.
I think it'll be pretty successful. You might be surprised how many, you know, how many of the audiences overlap.
Right. Now Matt says perfect. I like them hairy. So let's talk so serious now, Matt. Matt's a urologist, right?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
He's a penis doctor.
Right.
So Matt, you know, all the trend, you know, a lot of men are shaving themselves now. You know, one of my friends and his wife go to the swing club, and you know, he shaves himself, head to toe. He's smooth at the swinger club. All right. Are there any health benefits for men in shaving their pubic hair, or is it more beneficial to keep it as is? And do you ever look at one of your patients and say, hey, you got to shave that thing. You got a freaking forest growing in there.
See, these are good questions.
These are good, legit questions now. So he said correct, but I'm not sure what.
I think he meant correct. I'm a penis. Yeah, correct. He's the penis doctor.
Yes.
Penis surgeon. There you go. Yeah, these are good questions. We should know.
Matt, I'd be called a polar bear in the gay community. Okay.
Yeah, you know, you could get Matt as your first caller on Chatterbait. So you know, taking live Q&A with the penis doctor.
And once again, and you wonder why my YouTube channel doesn't get promoted, why none of the videos get, because we're shadow banned because of our content, but it's the best show on YouTube.
Yeah, you know, and I think that's even more of a reason to switch over to Chatterbait, because yes. What is YouTube doing for you?
Nothing. Matt says, I've had to shave a scrotum during a vasectomy. Yeah. Matt, did you ever have, after you did the vasectomies, which stops a man from getting the lovely ladies pregnant, did you ever have a patient come back and say, can you undo it? Is there ever buyer remorse, I guess would you call it? Would you call it buyer remorse? Did you ever have to undo it? And I don't even know if that's medically possible. Tana said we might get Al promoted on the main page. That would be the, yeah. Yeah, we talk about life goals. That would be funny.
I mean, let me look up who's on the front page of there now.
Are you on your VPN? shit.
Let's see.
Gasper, penile remorse. Oh wow, he's undone it. That's amazing, Matt. We might have to get you as a guest caller. By the way, you know you have three children, and now your wife just gave birth to a fourth. You have a very busy house. I mean, how is the chaos? Are you guys, you and your wife, getting sleep? And did the sex stop now at this point? Todd says, I've seen a urologist in February for my kidney stone, of course. You had a stoned kidney. You got to drink cranberry juice. It would be good for you.
You know, it would be great if you had the CEO of OWC as a live caller on Chatterbait. Yeah,
great. Matt said, though, the reverse of the vasectomy is indeed difficult and does not work all the time. Wow, I guess, okay, so there is buyer remorse, penile remorse. Yeah. Interesting. And all right, Klingon Princess is heading out. Take care of your stuff, Miss Evangeline. Klingon Princess signing off. We give her a gong, or one of our fine moderators on the Alpha.TV Discord channel. Actually, we have quite a few people watching. 26, which is higher than the average 15. I guess you listen. I miss doing this crap for you all. This is, and I do it for you all, for you all. So, Vin, Matt says it is chaotic. I can only imagine. We have a lot of help. Sex is off the table for 6 weeks. Okay. It makes sense. But I'm glad you have some help in the house, and hopefully your wife is feeling better. You know, it's exciting. My niece is getting excited. I mean, she's a little bit more than halfway through. So we'll have a new duty machine up in sometime in August. So that will be good. And thank you again for your input on iPhone and a camera. I will share that with her. Zach says, still can't wait to see that interview with the OWC CEO when it happens. Yeah, I really got to put that back online. Larry, if you really wanted to do it, it just things. Listen, I've been busy, you know, and you know I had an injury that kind of knocked me off course, but I'm getting back on track with things. So, Vin, though, you did a little research on current conspiracy theories. What do you got?
I did not get to do so much research today because I was dealing with a leak.
Why you have a urologist in the room? What was leaking?
My ceiling.
Oh, your ceiling.
We had a pretty bad storm here today.
Huh.
Yeah, so I had a leak in the ceiling. It was annoying.
Yeah. Did you put like a can underneath it type of thing with the drip, drip, drip type of?
Yeah, I put like a bucket underneath and my cat kept trying to knock it over. it was annoying.
Little bastards. You know, one of my neighbors, she's taking a road trip and, you know, I've been in her apartment and the cat knows me and the cat will roll down, you know, roll on its side and show its belly so the animal's comfortable with me. So she said, you know, Alpha, when I go and take a road trip for a couple of days, you know, I'm going to give you the keys and I want you to take care of the cat. I said, not a problem. And the way she feeds it like intermittent fasting, like small meals throughout the day. Like she feeds the thing like 7 times. You know, small meals and then the dry food and then whatever, like this whole routine. So as I'm sitting there with the cat, I'm petting the cat. I'm like, oh, I can't wait for your mother to leave. I'm going to feed you a whole fucking can of food all at once. She's like looking at me. Yeah, I'm going to give you the good shit. None of that fancy treat shit. You're going to get a can of like legit human tuna. You're going to get the good shit. And a can of salmon from Costco. Nice. Whole can. You're going to be so stuffed. You're going to, like, hey, where's the food? So I'm rattling her up a little bit because she likes the routine that the cat is on. Muck says you need Flex Seal. I got that Flex Seal shit. It's pretty good. You have Flex Seal?
Flex Seal?
Yeah, you're not familiar with that? You never saw the commercial for Flex Seal?
No, what's that?
You can get it at, like, Home Creepo or Ace Hardware. It's they have it in tape form, spray form, and like goo form in a can, and it's a quick and dirty, like Gasper's underwear waterproofing system. Flex Seal, yeah, look it up. Really, Is the leak still going?
No, it stopped because it was a leak that was coming from my upstairs neighbor's ceiling, which is where the roof is.
Okay, so it's not from where the bathroom is because that would be. That would be a serious problem if the seal, the wax seal around the bathroom, you know, you'd be getting some nasty stank water down there.
Yeah, no, it was a pretty bad, I mean, like at first it was like a stream of water.
Right.
And then it just drip, drip, drip. And, you know, I went upstairs and knocked on the door and no one's home. So I had to call the super and the super was like, oh, I might be too busy today. I can come tomorrow. I'm like, I kind of need you to come today.
Right.
Yeah. Like, it's dripping a lot.
So did they bust into the apartment and did they find P. Diddy with... was it a freak out party going on up there?
Yeah, I don't know. He went up there and he put I guess he put a bucket up there and then he gave me some buckets for down here.
So he basically said, fuck it. Gave me a bunch of buckets. All right, yeah. So you had a damp day. Okay, well, hopefully that gets resolved. And Gasper corrected me. He said it should be not Ace Hardware, it's Ass Hardware. Gasper says it rained pretty bad late last year, and the ceiling at work literally fell apart, damaging some merchandise in store. Wow, okay. Wow. Listen, you know, Gasper... If it fell on your head, you could have had a nice multi-million-dollar lawsuit. Wow, you can give me hearts now in the chat? How come I don't see those hearts going? Like, someone press something.
Oh, yeah.
You can do like a heart. Oh, wow, look at that. So what, every time you press that, it further clogs my arteries?
I guess so, yeah.
Is that the way? Right now, they're going to start banging it now. Yeah, right. Yeah, fuck
That's
you
good.
All.
Maybe it'll get you in the algorithm.
Yeah, right. Does it help the algorithm?
I think so. I think it shows that people are... Who knows?
Yeah, we're a highly interactive crowd. So what did... I'm really getting chest pains now. You poking that thing. What did you find out though about on the conspiracy side? What'd you see?
We got the P. Diddy stuff. He was, I think some family members are suing the FBI for like.
Wait a second. Matt says, I'm off to bed, Al. Be dreaming of you. Oh, yeah, we're going to need him on that chat you made. All right, Matthew, regards to your wife and congrats on the new child. Thank you for tuning in. I really appreciate it. You stay well, doctor. I have to call him doctor now. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
I think some of his family members are suing or something. I saw on the news this morning for like. What do you call that? Like, I forget what the term is, but they're like, yeah, that it was, you know, they went over the top with the rating of the house.
Oh, okay. So like, you know, excessive force.
Excessive force.
Right. I heard on one of the news feeds that they had like, you know, the children, the son or sons, they had like, you know, red dots on their chest, you know, from the guns and whatever. So, okay. All right. So he's going to do one whole big shit show. Right?
Right. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
And then there's obviously some conspiracies about that earthquake in Taiwan.
Oh, what? Jewish space lasers? What are they saying on this one?
Yeah. The space lasers are at it again, I guess.
Really?
It's the, you know, the government's weather control gone awry and, you know, this and that.
Okay.
I mean, it's an earthquake.
You know, I had read that the people at HAARP, you know, that do the atmospheric tests and whatnot, the facility. Are you familiar with HAARP?
Yeah, yeah.
All right. It's that like large array of antennas where they bounce signals off the ionosphere to do ionosphere experiments. And I guess they're done with the experiments. They're so sick of the conspiracy theories that they think about like disassembling the whole system, like just to shut everyone up. I think that's funny.
Jeez.
Yeah, we're gonna take it down. No, we're not controlling the fucking weather.
Yeah, I mean it's and then it's like no matter what you tell people, it's always, you know, you can give them all the factual evidence that you want, and then they're still going to justify their own confirmation bias in their head.
Well, listen, and like I've said many times, if you take some of these conspiracy theories and you take 10 steps back, there is some truth in some of them, you know? We do have methods of controlling the weather. There is a way to do some cloud seeding. It's real. You know,
right.
We can make it rain. You know, we're not pushing a button, though, with an antenna array, you know? And everything is corrupt. And there's no secret cabal, as I've said. It's just a cabal. Everything is run by the ultra, ultra, ultra elites.
Right.
Control the money. You know, they make this all that's going on. You know, and you look at the Ukraine war and the money that we're sending to them. But we're not running them a check. Where's the money going? It's going to the U.S. defense companies to build weapons. You know,
right?
It's not that we're sending them a bucket of cash. You know, it's so who in Congress has, you know, bought the stocks low for the defense company? You know, it's a fucking all one big fucking smoke screen of bullshit.
Yeah, you know, if you want to make money, just follow whatever Paul Pelosi is buying in the stock market.
Right. I think they have like a window of 90 days to report what they're buying.
Yeah.
Whereas like if a board member, like if Tim Apple sells or buys more personal shares or sells some of his shares, he has to disclose that within, I think it's like 48 hours.
Right.
And there's a website with the SEC that tracks all that data. It's I forgot the name of that. I think it's called the Edgar. Look it up. The Edgar database. Type in SEC and Edgar and see what it vomits out. It's really a very good resource to share as we talk about our Discord server being a suppository of information.
SEC Edgar search tonight.
Yeah. You find it?
Yeah, yeah. I think. Edgar search and access.
Yeah, can you share the link?
New versatile tool lets you search for keywords and phrases. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, we're going to share it to you. We're going to share it with you. This, now, it doesn't, like I said, Congress, those bastards who think they're above everyone else, they do insider trading. Let's face it. Yeah, they're voting on policies and whatever, and then they're buying stocks.
Right.
And they require like within a 90-day window. But, you know, corporate executives have to report within, I think it's 48 hours. So he's going to share the database. The data is collected by the SEC, and it's made public. So there it is. So if you are into investing and want to learn a little bit more about who's selling what, there's the stink link.
Yeah, that's a pretty good, that's a good resource.
Yes, did I just teach you that?
Yeah.
Excellent.
Yeah,
bookmark it. on what browser? Opera?
Firefox.
What OS are you running?
On my Mac, I'm on one of my own. I think I'm on Ventura now. Ventura.
Is that the... No, Sonoma's the newest
one,
right?
Slonoma, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, and so I know, Vin, if you were listening, you know, the bottom of the barrel iMac was getting like 3 to 4 frames per second on the upscaling.
Yeah, that's good. I mean, yeah, that M1 is a lot of power compared to that trash can.
Yes. You know, I mean, all 8 cores were slammed. It has 4 efficiency cores and 4 whatever cores. What do they call them? Efficiency and main, I don't know. But yeah, so for $950 plus, well, the $500 for the extra storage, I mean, I'm very satisfied, you know? So I'll queue up, you know, I got to look at what I want to upscale. Some things I have to bring in from tape. I'll just leave, right. You've been here, sitting in the hutch in the living room.
Yeah.
Yeah, remote control into it and say, here, upscale. It's sitting rots. Right. Oh, performance cores and efficiency cores, right. And Apple a little bit sneaky on like the M3. They don't really boast about the ratio. Sometimes they knock out some of those the P cores, you know, and add in more efficiency core. Yeah, you know, they don't disclose that balance on the performance as much like they used to, you know.
Yeah.
But so are they going to have an M3, what's Ultra? What's after Ultra? Extreme?
It's Pro and then Max and then Ultra.
Right. And is there going to be an Extreme, which is going to be 2 Ultras?
Oh, that's a lot.
I hear rumors of that.
Rumors of that?
Yeah. Yes, because that's what I want.
That's a lot. What are you going to do with all that?
I'll open PDFs. Come on, yeah. Look at how fast we'll open a PDF.
Yeah.
You know?
And Muck, that's pretty fast, I bet.
Yeah, Muck says, what, Walmart is selling the M1 Air for $700. That's a pretty good deal.
I mean, I remember it was a big deal when, like...
Hey, you know what, Muck? That's a great... You know, my neighbor should just get that instead of the Slonovo. She has an iPhone.
That is a good deal.
I want to use an analog... Hey, I have the headphones down for a second, Vin. So it's Walmart, analog pen and pad. Walmart Air for $700. That's great. I think that would be a great laptop because, like I said, she's on an iPhone, you know?
Right.
Yeah, very good. Thank you for that, Muck. Yeah. Anyway. How's the market?
I've got another conspiracy for you about that earthquake.
Yeah, go ahead.
So the other conspiracy about that is that the ultra elite are building tunnels to escape the solar eclipse, and the tunnels, one of them collapsed and set off a huge earthquake, the likes of which that the place hasn't seen in a while.
Why do they have to escape the eclipse? What's the problem?
That's a good question. They're escaping the eclipse because... Here, and I'm reading it from the thing. It says, during that time, mass events will unfold. Earthquakes, tornadoes, volcanoes, lava, and da-da-da. It's going to be mass chaos for the short period of time that the sky turns dark.
Huh. Well, why? Are we in medieval times again? I mean...
I believe so, yeah. This is nothing new. We've had eclipses before.
Of course. And when is the eclipse? When is it?
It's on Monday.
Oh, okay. And what is it? It's the moon going in front of the sun.
Right.
And that can certainly hurt your eyes, correct?
Yeah, don't stare at it with your naked eye.
No, you can't, right? Very dangerous. Yeah. You'll burn your retina out.
You certainly will. If you live in New York City, you can go to the any public library, and they're giving away the free glasses with the filter.
I don't trust that shit either.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, if you do it and you get blind, you can sue the city for. Yeah.
Listen, my I have no. I want to look at it through an Apple Vision Pro. Yeah. Whatever.
Yeah. So. You know.
What time?
You still should put a filter in front of your camera lens as well.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I'm just joking. No, I mean, I'm like I said, the eclipse is not going to really do anything for me. What time is it eclipsing at?
That is a good question. Let me find out. What time is the eclipse?
And I don't know, what's really the big deal in the allure? Like, oh my God, I want to watch the eclipse. Like, hurry.
It's a cool looking thing, I guess. It's like the moon going in front of the sun.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know.
Like, it gets a whatever. It's pretty amazing, though, how, like, you know, how distance-wise, size-wise, relative, everything all kind of worked out, that the moon just about covers it perfectly. And there's a conspiracy theory around that, you know.
Yeah, I mean, it always sets off, like, the religious theories. You know, you got the evangelicals on TV now asking for donations because this is a sign from God.
Really?
It's really just a calculated event. I mean, it's the rotation of the sun and the moon and the earth, and just kind of coincides. It's kind of something we knew was going to happen. It's not a random event.
Huh.
Okay, so it says New York, it starts around like 2:04 and then goes until like 4:34.
2:04 to 4:34. Look, good time to stay inside and play on your Xbox. What the hell?
Yeah.
I said, still the best line. I think it was by Danny Minnick during COVID lockdown. We've been preparing for this for years as tech people.
Yeah.
It's a, like I said, a whatever. No, yeah, listen, right. But Vin, I'm glad you had a, oh shit, just lost my screen. Wait, did I lose my Jigglypuff button?
Oh
there,
no.
There it is.
Welcome to TV.
I really got to program more shit into the soundboard, especially since we edited and isolated all that stuff from that Halo guy.
Oh, yeah, you got to put those up.
Yeah. Matt says, I mean, where I am at in Florida, we are getting a 60% eclipse, so there will be only 60% chaos here. We always have some good I tell you, it drives me crazy every time I see some stupidity, like, you know, on YouTube, and like, oh, are these people from Florida? And who was the first one I did that? Island Boys. Oh, Jesus Christ. No, it wasn't the Island Boys. No, the first one was Cash Me Outside Girl.
Oh, she's great.
She's from Boynton Beach. She's from South Florida.
Get her on the show.
No, yeah, I'm multi-billionaire now, something like that now. But yeah, she. So that was the first. Gosh darn it, Florida, and then Island Boys. Oh crap, they're Florida again. Then this idiot Jack Doherty harassing people at the Aventura Mall. Yeah, Florida, Diddy, Florida. But it's all Florida. Holy shit, you know?
Yeah, that, you know, there's that joke. It's like, if you just go into Google and type in Florida man and then type in your birthday and see what the headline is.
Yeah. Gosh darn it. Zach says the Texas Department of Motor Vehicles will prohibit vehicles with oversized or overweight permits from traveling in countries that fall within the path of totality April 8th. Path of totality. What? In other words, total darkness?
Oh, yeah.
Why? Can they just put the headlights on? What's the problem?
I think it's more of like they don't want drivers to be distracted. Like, oh, look at that.
I just burned out my eyes. I can't see shit.
Right.
So, yeah. Whatever. Anyway, I think I'm going to wrap this up, Vin. You have anything else you want to share with this fine, outstanding, mature, sophisticated, educated, tech-centric audience?
No, not really. Oh, yeah, I do, actually. I'm going to put up a poll on the Discord to decide what the next movie night movie is going to be.
Okay, did you see that trio that I suggested?
Yes, I screenshotted that for...
Did you know any of those movies?
I think I saw... What was the one? I definitely heard of them.
Okay, I mean, those are good. Those would be three good choices for a tech-centric audience.
Yeah, I'll keep those in mind for next week, but or for the week after. But for this next coming one on Monday, I'm going to put up a poll.
Wait a second. Matt says, I saw a Florida man headline where he was a quadriplegic, no arms and legs, yet he was considered armed and dangerous. That's funny.
Only in Florida.
Mux says, bring back the iAlpha 34 content. Yeah, I just realized that channel's not even monetized. Anyway, I interrupted you. Go ahead.
Okay, so the poll will be between Alien or Predator. So technically Alien versus Predator, but not the movie Alien versus Predator. It'll be the movie Alien versus the movie Predator.
Okay, is the movie Predator about Jeffrey Epstein?
No.
Or Diddy?
It's Diddy, yeah.
No, well, who's the other guy? Weinstein? Who's the big movie guy that was...
It's the new one for the guy from Nickelodeon.
There's another guy that's in trouble?
Yeah, there was like a documentary called Quiet on Set, and it was about like all the dark stuff that happened at Nickelodeon in the 90s.
Really bad stuff with them too, huh?
Yeah.
Everyone needs a kick in it. Listen... You want to go the Bible God route? This whole planet's going to get wiped. It's going to be the Great Recess. That's what's going to come to. You know.
Yeah. Hopefully they're using flushable wipes.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes. I am. It's good.
Yeah.
Oh, Gaspar, his chat refreshed. Gaspar said the movie Predator is about Catholic priests.
Yeah. There you go.
Dan getting the Van Schneider. Oh, God. Listen, I had to take a break from the news. I started watching old episodes of The Gong Show, shitty transfers from VHS tape. Funny as hell. It was a talent show from the 70s and just funny as hell.
Did they, like, hit the gong when you won?
Or? No, they hit the gong if you sucked.
Right, okay.
Yeah,
kind of like how in, like, America's Got Talent where they hit the buzzer.
Yes.
Kind of thing.
But it was so cheesy and so chaotic and live. And the jokes, just go on there and watch one from the 70s with Chuck Barris as the moderator. And it's really good stuff. It's funny as hell.
Yeah, check that out. Yeah. The Gong Show.
Yes, The Gong Show. All right, Vin, I'm going to wrap this up because I need some sleep. I'm old.
Okay.
But thank you for calling in. We're going to try to, like I said, we're going to try to stay on schedule. So we got, well, you heard, we got the Franco is coming, the seniors.
Yeah, that's good. You know, you should get David to come for Halloween Horror Nights.
I was trying to get him to come down here when the family was down. I can suck Jess that. Well, he wants to be a calling guest. So,
okay.
You know, yeah. we'll tell him. On the call. And another, I want to try with you on a future webcast or maybe a test broadcast if I can get your video feed going so they don't have to just look at me.
Yeah, didn't we do that once a while back?
I think we did, and I think I got it working, and we'll try.
Yeah, we should also try and get Discord working with your whole system there.
Didn't
you say it wasn't working with Wirecast or something?
No, the problem, Discord doesn't like my interface, the audio interface, for some reason.
Huh.
It just freaks out. Don't know why. But whatever. All right, Vin. Listen, enjoy the rest of your evening. I normally say enjoy almost your weekend, but it's only Wednesday.
Yeah.
So just enjoy.
Yeah, I'll enjoy.
All right, Vin. Thanks for calling in.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
The great Vin Doria. And yeah, so... yeah, Gasper, yeah, save a few shekels. America's Got Talons. That's funny. Mucks his time to build by bunker. Well, whatever. Anyway, listen. Thank you all for tuning in. I do this for you. I hope you had a couple of laughs. Maybe you might even learned a few things. Definitely watch the Leaser video, the upscale with the iMac. The quality's pretty good. You know, and I got a nice frame rate going there. And all good. And yeah, so more to come. Mordecai! Stay tuned. And I'll see you all soon. And always... Oh, Mac, this doesn't get along with any interfaces. Apparently a known issue. Oh, wow. Klein, thank you. All right, so I thought it was just me. So this is like a known thing, that, though. It has trouble with interfaces. Okay. Thank you. I appreciate you sharing that. Thank you so much. I have such a smart audience. It's the best. So... the biggest thing challenge for me now is how to properly stop the stream. I know I have to press buttons, but enjoy the rest of your night, y'all. How do I stop this fucking thing?